This past weekend, I actually had the rare opportunity to play a full country gig with a singer from Nashville named Daisy Sellis. She is actually originally from here. She moved to Nashville. She's doing demos and doing all the cool things that people do in Nashville. She works at Tootsie's bar and stuff like that, doing the full Nashville experience. But she came home to sing and play at our local rodeo. So it was my first rodeo, as they say. But also, it was a fun opportunity for me to actually learn a whole lot of country music, contemporary country music, classic country music, a bunch of Daisy's originals, which were pretty cool. And in doing that, I kind of had to set up a preset on my FM3 that would actually fit all of this stuff without too much preset changing. I had about 35 or so, maybe close to 40 songs by the time we were done that I had to put together. And at the core of it, I wanted a good clean sound. And then I needed to have different kinds of lead sounds that were appropriate to the style of music. So I took my basic 59 basement sound that I use for a lot of my other stuff and kind of built off of it. So that's the preset we're looking at today, the rodeo preset. So this first scene here is just my clean sound. I think I might have, well, I don't know, it doesn't look like I turned up the drive very much. If I go to my regular basement preset, let's just kind of compare for a second. This is what I normally use on gigs, and this was kind of the starting point. I copied this over to another place and then built what I needed off of that. Right, so we've got the 59 Bass Guy Bright. For cabinets, I'm using the 4x10 Bass Guy with either the 57 or the 160, kind of a combination of the two. And we've got a little bit of delay. I really love tape delays for a lot of these sounds. And even though you don't really hear it, like it's. It's kind of in there, you know, it adds a little bit of depth. Same thing with my reverb. I'm using a spring reverb on this. On stage, this actually almost disappeared. Everything felt really dry because we were playing outdoors. I'll put some pictures up of what we were doing. But this is just my basic clean sound. I took the wah block out of the original sound because I'm not using it. But that also helped me with some of the other sounds and scenes I needed. So my typical basement sound, the second scene, is basically this scene with an RC booster. Same idea. But what I wanted to do was I wanted to use the wah pedal or the expression. Give me a rhythm sound that was a little dirtier. So here's the clean sound. Has a slight amount more just expression pedal it up for solos. I'm usually not a volume pedal guy, so this was kind of a stretch for me, but you'll see here in a second, actually in about a minute or two, I kind of had to use volume swells for certain one tune in particular, and that kind of changed how I thought about this preset. So we've got the clean sound with the RC booster as a lead sound. And also has a rhythm sound. And that allowed me to do some stuff without basically adjusting at the volume pot, which is how I normally do. On gigs, I usually ride my volume pot pretty hard. So that's what's going on here. I've got the volume. When it's all the way back, it ends up being at about 6.15. When I bring it up, it should be at 100. Not sure why it's not. Huh, very odd. I'll have to look into that. But basically, that's kind of that scene. And then the third scene is kind of my slapback country kind of. And all we have here is we have the clean basement volume set up again. I'm using a Dynacomp. Trying to get that classic. Anytime I needed something a little bit more traditional like that. that's kind of what I was using. So, and sometimes, there's a, is it Sonny Sweeney song, Bad Girl Phase? Right, and it had kind of a lick to it that needed to pop out every once in a while. So that's what I had for that. So I use that sound a bunch. We have a tremolo sound. There's one or two songs that really needed kind of a washy sound. One of them. I don't remember the name of these guys. Ain't Much Left of Me by Blackberry Blossom. I don't know. I'll put it in the thing below. But basically, I needed that sound for that tune, and there was a bit of a Gretchen Wilson. Redneck Woman. No, actually, I take that back. Gunpowder and Lead by Miranda Lambert. That's how a little country music I play. I have to think really hard about all this stuff. But there's one part on the bridge where they use kind of a big tremolo thing, and I just didn't have enough scenes for all this. But it worked for that kind of a deal. Kind of in and out of there. So that's the tremolo. And the tremolo I use is not one I normally use either. It's the harmonic trem. On my presets, I'm usually either using the optical or the bias trem. And a little bit of reverb. Most of my reverbs here are the large spring. The next scene here is the... Actually, I switched amps. After messing with this for quite a while, I kind of went to the JTM-45. So I'm going to 86 the Tube Screamer for a second. This is the amp. I like that. And I'm using... Actually, this is a Leon Todd, I believe, TV Mix Live. This is one of his. It's actually probably my favorite I already use for Marshall-y or crunchy. And that's actually in the Axe Exchange. I think I could probably save this preset with this IR built into it. But if I don't, if it's breaking the rules on the Fractal Axe Exchange, this will be taken out, but you can just find it. I'll put a link to that too. It's just a great cabinet for just general Marshall kind of things. So what I did on top of that was Tube Screamer, TS-808. There was a Taylor Swift song. Alright, it kind of had that sound. This was a little wetter, a little bit more a stereo tape. I'm not even sure why I'm using the stereo version. I think it was just like one of the presets in the delay block, and I liked it. So this also has the volume on the expression pedal, so I could use this as a rhythm. So with the volume, like I was, the other one with the volume pedal all the way down, it just basically takes me not super quiet, but actually to where I wanted it for my rhythm. Preset number 6 is actually the same amp and cab as the 808. For whatever reason, with the pedals, I just like this better. And I'm using the BB Pre, the exotic BB Pre. That just kind of worked best for like any kind of real like. Like those kinds of rock lead kind of things. This one does not have the volume control. It's set literally to, if I needed something that needed to punch out over the top of everything, this was set at that loud.
Volume.
And then the last two scenes here, we played Dreams by Fleetwood Mac. And I never played any Fleetwood Mac before. With this one, the volume actually had to go all the way down. And there's a lot of, you know. A lot of those kinds of swells. And actually, I should be playing that with my fingers. And then, so that's the wet dream sound, and then I had the same sound, just dry. And I kind of did a little bit of a deep dive on the Fleetwood Mac thing just because it was fun, and I really haven't researched much Fleetwood Mac. I've liked some of the music, but I really haven't had to play any of it. And I noticed that he, for a certain portion of his the 70s, used high-watt amps. So I basically just set up a high-watt sound. And then with this, all right, we're back. One of the things that's nice about this preset is that it works pretty good as a general, clean or rock and roll kind of thing, especially with the Telecaster. This is not a particularly special Telecaster. It's my 2011. It's the 60th anniversary, but in reality, that means it's an American standard with, I think, Tex-Mex pickups in it, right? It's not a high-end guitar. But I love how it sounds, and it works really good with this preset, especially the 59 Bassman. It's probably my favorite guitar. Like I was saying, it actually works pretty good. Like if I was going to do a classic rock gig or something that wasn't real specific on modulation sounds, this would actually be a pretty good all-around preset. I might ditch the Fleetwood Mac stuff maybe and put like a chorus or a phaser sound in there or something that I'd use a little bit more often. But in reality, it's pretty close and it's pretty functional to what I do, except for it doesn't have the wah block in it, which I have enough CPU left over in this, I could probably stick a wah block in there for one or two presets if I needed. I just kind of like having the wah where it can be turned on at any time or it's off at any time by having the pedal back. You know, I kind of do that sort of thing. But, you know, this is actually the process of building this has kind of made me really rethink how I do some of my other sounds. So you may see some changes in my main live sounds based off of this as well. So in any event, I'm going to make this preset available on the Axe-Jange. I'll put links below, and you know, subscribe, hit like, and visit our forum and all of our other stuff. We've got lessons, gear reviews, and backing tracks. Actually, the most popular things on my channel, believe it or not, are the backing tracks. So if you're looking for something to practice over, look for those guys too. Thanks.